Anything difficult is always welcome. The truth is that when it comes to construction, at least in this country, there is something, I don't know if I should mention, but I mean, think about it, there's so many things that can happen.
If we had to compare the process of a resale and a new build, where is the problems most likely to occur in the process? And there's no insurance going in here and covering, or how does that work?
That's crazy. Well, that's the other back. Ben Ahavi right now is doing the right thing. Step One is doing it as well. We are the authority. Less problems on a reform, far less problems.
Far less than this one.
Yeah. Time is money.
There is so much going on.
It's not just the actual time. Construction is a big thing.
Momentum.
Yeah. You're saving a lot of money. Make it easy for investors.
Yeah.
The variables and parameters, we can double that in our area at least. All of that can be done if you do not alter the actual footprint. It's a very interesting thing.
Today I want to introduce to you Jesus.
I mean, we put a man on the moon.
Some of you might remember Jesus from previous videos.
It is classic, but it has a modern touch.
A Mojo approved architect. Why are you wearing jacket? It's like 20 degrees or 30.
Well, he's wearing it as well.
They fucked up.
At a mile alarm,
no? No.
Why don't you... Sunshine. Too much noise. Or here even. So let me just think. Okay. Is it too noisy?
It's a little bit.
It's all about your mojo.
That's a new law.
That's a new law, yeah. Approved a year ago.
A new law approved in 2020 gives us architects the power to actually grant, put it this way, license to full renovations of villas under our supervision, under our responsibility. We don't have to wait for the town hall. Okay.
That's what you're doing on our villa project.
To the new villa.
Yeah.
That's why we started so quickly.
Yeah.
The whole idea from the start was to transform this house completely.
We started straight away.
Yeah.
Well, how did we do that? We went to this new law and basically took advantage of it. I mean, took advantage of it. You know, benefited from it straight
benefited,
away.
Benefited, yeah.
And most of the Costa del Sol have hundreds of fantastic villas that are aging now, you know, very old, that need renovation.
So the topic of today is to meet with Jesus and discuss the differences between taking on a resale property versus a new built property starting all over from scratch.
The final product is the same, at least every time I get involved.
Yeah.
So you might get a villa 50 years old or 40 years old, renovate it entirely and make it look brand new as if it had just been built, recently built. The difference between doing that on an existing villa, renovating, or building it from scratch is the timescale. 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 20% of the job is left to be done. We're more or less at 80% right now. We should be ready before the end of the summer.
Would you be able to recreate that on an existing villa? Or is there fundamentally something here that you just cannot pull over an existing resale villa reform?
Well, and when it comes to quality, absolutely not. There is no difference whatsoever.
This view here is absolutely incredible.
Yeah, well, that was the whole purpose of, basically, we call it the wow factor. That's important always on a villa here in the Costa del Sol.
You get that here?
Yeah, you do. Wow. You do get that here. All the new houses that are built nowadays, all the installations they're equipped with, you can use all that on a full renovation villa.
Yeah.
You're just using the skeleton, structure. The rest is completely new installations, underfloor heating, air conditioning, electric installations, absolutely everything that you can think of can go into that new house.
Yeah.
Just keeping the structure, or maybe fixing the structure whatever it's been weakened over the years or however, but changes massively, you know, legal-wise, makes it much so much easier.
It's very strange distributed from
distribution. Distribution is
you'll rip it all apart.
Yeah, and I make mistakes, and I change things, but that's the way it works.
Yeah, it is.
I always tell my client, listen, the project is something that's alive through the whole process.
Yeah.
And I always tell the example of the fashion designer. The fashion designer is touching up models just before they're on the catwalk. That's exactly the same. So, you know, you need to work like that. I only work like
that. A little flower.
Many people have realized that now, and there's a lot of renovation projects going on. And I have clients that do that, make a lot of profit.
And you're my client.
Yeah, well, I'm his client.
Kitchen's on the top floor.
That's so weird. Everything's weird. Wow, I love these tiles. I love them. I love these.
But, what really, really shocked me is the railings.
Yeah.
That is.
I've never seen anything like that.
No, that's insane, right?
And probably made out
of wood. Andalusian bodega meets German beer.
Something they're made out of wood.
You know, it's basically having an architect or a professional or even a client himself with a lot of vision that can actually see the potential of an existing 40-year-old villa.
One versus the other.
So from a time perspective, we should go for resale reform villas.
Reform existing villas, if you want to. Yeah. I mean, if you want like a short-term deal.
Yeah.
You know, you want to make money pretty quickly in construction. Because I mean, this client will make a lot of money when he sells this villa.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. But I heard you mention the numbers before last time I was here, so I'm not going to go into that, but that's a huge profit here.
Yeah, huge profit here, but it's been like a 4-year project, you know, he's has to put all the money up front, basically.
Yeah, yeah.
He's got the profit is magnificent.
Jesus, he's not just an average architect, if I could put it that way. He really deals with mansions like luxury villas. Yeah. What's going on here? Because this looks like an airport terminal.
Well.
Just entering.
Yeah, that's the thing with Marbella. We need to impress on every new project. The level here is of clients are very demanding and you need to surprise them. And that's not easy when we talk about clients that have been all over the world and have seen everything. But that's what we do here, you know. That's what Marbella. I mean, me as a professional, this is what I've always done.
Yeah.
Luxury villa. So our standards here are very high. The cost of construction probably will rise this year 5%.
Yeah.
We are having like 3 and 4 updates annually on construction materials now. I've never seen anything like that.
Wow.
Every year we would have one update from like major suppliers.
Yeah.
We've had this year,
wow,
3 already, and there's a 4th coming before the end of the year.
And if this continues, like, it will probably be another 5% next year.
Yeah, yeah.
That is true. Marbella has a massive demand right now.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people with a lot of money, mainly in Europe, that want to be here.
Yeah.
Because really, we have no competition. Okay, I was born and raised here, but it's not bad. But we have no competition.
No.
And look at this, right?
Yeah, we have the sun.
So, all I'm saying is that, you know, it's a good chance right now that the prices are more or less reasonable now, to go ahead and do your project and the cost of the song.
It's the time to buy. Says the realtor and the architect.
Yeah. I can't think of any disadvantages whatsoever.
I heard the other day that Sagaleta this year is the best-selling year ever, ever.
You're in real estate, so you would know better.
And generally here in Spain, it's the year where most properties have been sold since just before the financial crisis.
Well, that's more or less what I've heard, but real estate has always been a good investment. Hardly ever loses value. I mean, it has happened, but not now. I mean, you buy something here and the price will only go up even if you don't do anything to it.
Yeah.
Just by getting a project, not even building anything, if you get the project and you get the license, you're adding at least 30-40% value on top of what you've actually bought.
That's for sure.
Because investors are looking for ready-to-go projects.
Yeah.
We get the license either through responsible declaration or through the normal channels. And just that adds fantastic value to the property.
Yeah.
You know, they've made maybe 30-40% profit or 50% profit within a year or 6 months.
So how much property are we looking at here? How much built here?
Oh, we're doing a very big villa. It's over 1,500 square meters.
That's a big one.
I'm glad you like it.
Yeah, let's go outside and have a look.
We can make very big things. We can actually, formalize within 3 weeks.
Because that's a big thing for our clients. Yeah. And most of them are looking for resale villas to reform. And as you said, the time is a big factor, right? How long should they expect?
And not just the requirements, legal requirements for an entire renovation of an existing villa are far less. Bear in mind, you don't have to do geological surveys unless you come across something, problematic. There's many things you don't have to do. It takes less time to to get started, less time to build. You're saving money, obviously, yes. On construction, and the final result is worth the same.
Yes.
If it is satisfactory, it is worth the same than any other new villa, because obviously they look, there's no way in the world you can really tell that that was an old villa that has been renovated. That's what I do. So most of my projects right now, 70% of them are renovation, entire renovation of existing villas.
Can you just break down the process of this one as an example?
It took 4 months because we did not have to amend anything on the project. The project was right at the first time.
Yes.
On the first attempt.
Okay.
Which is also unusual. Yep. But in our case, you know, when you've been working so many years as I have, they choose me, first of all, for the trust, secondly, because I'm cheaper.
That's why we chose them. Let's go out here and let's do one more because now they're not noisy.
Well, everything I'm saying,
I love it.
Yeah?
Just roll because it's like, it's authentic, you know? And now they're not noisy, so we can... Simon, can we stand here? Oh. So maybe you're here? Maybe you're here, like this side? Where do you want us?
Applying for a new build license would take at least 1 year.
Yeah.
You know, between the project being completed, submitted, the town hall getting back to you, and so on. It would take at least a year. It's pretty frustrating for everyone. You can't really make plans on short notice. But when it comes to renovating an existing villa, 40, 50 years old, most of them built in this country pretty solidly. Okay, yeah. We're talking about that a villa from the 70s, 80s is made out of reinforced concrete that can last hundreds of years. So it might look very old, but it's a bone structure or it's a concrete structure is still there. So I always advise, I'm always myself very interested in those kind of projects. Why? For several reasons. First of all, the new regulations and the new laws allow us to actually start renovating that villa within a 2-3 week period since the minute we want to do it.
Yeah. That's a new thing, right?
That's a new thing. It's basically obtaining the license to build through a responsible declaration, okay? Always always supervised by a licensed architect.
Yes.
So basically, you just tell the town hall, I have an architect and I'm going to renovate all this as per the law, complying with the regulations. The architect is here to make sure that that is done, therefore I'm doing it, okay?
But you're not going directly to the town hall for allowance, you're going through a certified architect.
The town hall does not intervene whatsoever.
No, and that's the new thing.
That's a new thing. You do have to pay them taxes, obviously, as you did before, or as you do with any other client. That's around 5% of whatever the cost you declare. I mean, we've applied, well, not applied, we've actually obtained licenses by responsible declaration for hundreds of thousands of euros worth of construction.
Yes.
So we can make very big things. We can actually, you know, formalize within 3 weeks.
Yeah, on an existing
on an existing villa. That is the big difference.
What does that mean, the existing structure of the villa?
So basically, the villa, the new villa has to have the same footprint as the previous one.
Yeah.
You basically can strip the entire building. Yeah. You basically just remove everything except the skeleton.
Yeah.
And
let's just say, for an example, that you had a villa like that you're describing, and you maybe wanted to move the swimming pool. Would that require then an all over new building license or just a little?
Well, that is a key question there, because swimming pool, for example, is considered a minor intervention. So therefore, we could build a new pool, a brand new pool, using that system, that law.
But let me just stop you there, because one of the villas that you helped me go through with one of our clients, remember they had the pool a little bit down in the garden. We maybe want to move that up closer to the villa, the one in Los Monteros. Would that comply with what you're telling me now, or would you have to ask for a special permission to move that pool?
Just to put it plainly, any new thing that you build that has a roof on?
Yeah.
No.
If
it has a roof, that is considered as a new construction, an extension or whatever. It does require far more paperwork, far more bureaucracy. A pool doesn't have a roof.
Right.
Okay? It's basically a hole in the floor. And so therefore, it's not regarded as a major construction and can actually be carried out.
And this would also apply for, let's say, paddle courts? As long as the
paddle courts, tennis courts,
allows for it.
Tennis courts, pools, stuff like that. You know, a little, landscaping. All of that can be done within that
anything license. Without a roof, basically.
Anything without a roof.
Yes.
But we could not extend the house using that law. Uh-huh. Okay. However, many old houses were built and the foundations were never actually turned into a basement. No. So what, you know, the one thing that is pretty common to all these projects is that eventually we actually dig out everything under the house, which is permitted.
Yes.
Based on this. So we're technically extending, but when you extend downwards, that is legally allowed. Yes. Basements do not count when it comes to density.
No, but this can be turned into something really nice.
Yeah, yeah,
it's
yeah.
a big plot. Southwest
first thing, raise it. I think, well, that shack there should go, maybe put something, you know, use that legal space, but change it completely.
I know in Denmark, a lot of the clients that we represent are also professionals. And in Denmark, if you don't work within the agreed time frame for finishing your works, you get penalties. Yeah. How does that work in Spain?
Well, you know, any construction job is, you know, there's a contract signed previously. It's actually attached to a contract, which usually includes penalty clauses, includes many things.
Yeah.
The thing about Spain is, unlike other countries that I know,
yeah.
in this country, everyone knows about red tape bureaucracy.
Yeah.
We are a very bureaucratic country.
Yeah.
So when you sign a contract with a builder,
yeah.
that contract, attached to that contract, is a very, very detailed bill of quantities
mm-hmm.
with prices every single item.
Yeah.
Okay, there's also a time.
That's the way it should be.
That's the way it should be, and that's the way it is. Basically, what you do is the builder gets paid monthly based on you know what he's completed from that very long list. I've done this, that, tuck,
yeah.
you know, the quantity surveyor and architect supervisor, and then the client pays.
Yeah.
Okay. So he actually, he is paid in stages based on what he has achieved or what he has completed.
Yeah.
So let's say he hasn't turned up one month or there's been a lot of rain, which is a problem in Spain.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
When it rains, people don't want to work. So
that's one excuse.
The thing is, if they don't work, they don't get paid. You better work, bitch. When you have one only client, like this one in particular, right, and you're building, and this house is being built for him,
yeah.
there is a finishing date.
Yes.
Finishing date. If that finishing date is pushed back, that has to be justified. It has to be justified not because by, you know, proper reasons, acts of God, whatever, this and that. Because one thing is finishing the job, one thing is finishing the house,
mm-hmm.
but then another thing is getting the habitation license. That's the other important thing that has changed.
Mm-hmm.
Now habitation license is granted by us, by architects,
yeah,
so basically we can get it almost automatically, so if everything is right.
Yeah.
However, there's always a delay, and I must say, in many cases, that delay is the client's fault.
Yeah.
You're my client.
Yeah, I'm his client.
Other things, for example, all the street works, when you make a new villa, new construction, obviously sidewalks, footpaths, installations, well, you've got to dig out the street, the footpath, sidewalk, and so on. It's the town hall that has to do that by law.
Yeah.
You know? It's the water company that has to do that by law. It's the electric company. So unless you don't care, you go along and do it yourself. Obviously,
which
you might
is also what happens in Spain.
You face penalties from the town hall for doing that. Not you know, they're not actually clapping their hands when you do it. They basically say, well, you've touched that without our permission, therefore we fine you. I said, well,
yeah.
it's either that or waiting months or not knowing. You know, there's loads of stuff like that going on. But anyway, I don't want to scare anyone. Everything, you know, everything comes. There's always delays.
Mm.
I have actually built houses on time. I have actually built houses before the time.
Mm.
And I have.
It sounded funny when you said you actually built houses on time.
I have,
yeah. Of course.
On time, before time.
Yeah, that's better.
But normally there's always a delay.
Yeah.
2 months, 3 months, stuff like that.
Yeah.
I've never had problems with the clients. regarding that. Why? Because they're fully aware why the delay was.
And it's a very important upfront to have these conversations with clients so they know. Because Spain is just different. It's just different than in
we have
clients coming down from Denmark who are used to maybe building a little summer house or whatever, like in 3 months an apartment is done, gone, and they budget with that. In Spain, that is really, really a challenge. It's time is the biggest, biggest challenge here in Spain to complete.
In this house, for example, the neighbor was, or the neighbor at some point came up, his lawyer, saying that the boundary of our plot was not right. And therefore he sued that client. They had to stop construction for like 4 months just because of that.
Yes.
Okay, the guy actually went through all of that in order to stop this. He stopped this, eventually the judge, you know, we won the case and then we could start again. There's a lot of many things like that. So whenever I tell you that the construction is going smooth and that I'm very happy, listen, that's unusual. In your case, your construction is going smooth as hell. Everything is going really, really well. And we hope it, if it continues like that, we'll probably see, you know, it'll be finished by time, as we agreed. Yeah.
These are the things that are very hard to put into your Excel sheet and
this is not a Swiss clock.
No, Jacob. No.
Building a house like this is you can be happy if you have a delay of like 20% of the time.
When you work with not only us as professionals but other, let's say, investors, how do you present the reality of this? How do you prepare them for the journey of maybe a project that's just extended a year or year
usually
and a half?
Investors that do this regularly are aware.
Yeah.
When you tell them, listen, I am never really. When they ask me, you know, what construction like schedule time, I always say, well, listen, it's going to be like 12 months, 15 months. But obviously, you know, there can be unpredicted things coming up,
and this comes down to being out of your control, the Ayuntamiento, the town hall, the neighbors.
I'm not saying that they will be.
Likely. Let's use the word likely.
I'll stand behind those 12 months. I'll say I'll achieve those as long as there's no the money comes regularly. There's no problems with the town hall. There's no problems with that. Always saying that there is problems, external problems that not necessarily construction problems. Construction is easy.
Okay, guys, this was Jesús, one of our preferred and very, very helpful architects. And you have your own architect. You are an architect. You have your own construction building company.
Yeah. So that's which builds for my clients and builds for myself. Because don't forget, I'm a property developer.
Yeah.
So I am. My building company works for me.
Yeah.
Well, as a developer.
So you're in safe hands with this, guys. I have very good experience with you, and there you go.
Yeah.
It's all about you, Mojo. Always a pleasure to talk with you and
It's been great. It's been great. It's always nice to inform and make aware of what's actually going on here to people all over the world.
This is the man, the architect with his own building company. He is really, really good, guys.
Thank you, Jacob.
It's all about your mojo. It's all about your mojo.
Jeg synes, du var en vildere, Simon. What do you think?
Playboy Mansion.
And you forgot to kick it.
I did, did I?
All right.
Can I kick it?
Cool. You've seen enough, Jesus.
Sorry for being so drastic, but...
No, it's good. I like it like that.
Yeah. not everyone does.
Can I kick it? Yes, you can. Can I kick it?